In this episode, we will take a look at an unusual device for recording videos on a smartphone. This device outputs the image from the main camera of the phone and allows us to shoot ourselves in the best quality. Today we will figure out who this device is suitable for, as well as consider its pros, cons and features of use. Friends, hello everyone, Alex Yasni is with you. I was looking for a better way to film myself on the main camera for a long time because it has the best characteristics among all of those available on the phone. Unlike the selfie camera, it has a good sensor, optics, color reproduction, dynamic range and other important features. But how do we shoot ourselves on this camera if we can't see what's happening on the screen? Of course, there are different ways. For example, one option to output the image to a computer, laptop, tablet or another phone using special programs. I even have an episode on these topics and you can watch it if you want to start recording on the main camera right now. But the thing is, this option is complex to set up, it takes time and it restricts your movement because you need to be near these devices. There is a more practical option, a special mirror in the reflection of which we see the screen and everything that happens on it. But there are also some nuances here. Not the entire screen fits into such a mirror and it's small, so it's difficult to see anything on it from a distance of more than 1 meter. Therefore, I have always been looking for more convenient option and even wanted to develop a device myself similar to the one we are talking about today. But Newmowa company beat me to it and released a screen that I had long been thinking about. So today we will take a closer look at this gadget. I will tell you about its drawbacks and nuances because there is some limitation to its use. And at the end I will share my impression and tell you who needs this device and who doesn't. I think it will be interesting, so watch the video completely and don't forget to like to support my channel. The Newmowa vlog screen is a small display with the size of almost 4 inches. It has a resolution of 480 by 800 pixels, which is quite sufficient for such a small diagonal. It weighs only 100 grams and the thickness is also small. Inside there is an 800 mAh battery, which lasts for approximately 1.5 hours of recording at medium brightness. There are only 3 buttons on the body. One is for power on and off, the second for brightness adjustment, and the third for switching between modes of operation. We will talk about them a bit later. On the other side, we have a Type-C connector and an indicator light, which lights up during charging and turns off when the device is fully charged. The build quality is quite nice, I wouldn't say it's some cheap trinket, everything is well made. The package includes the display itself, a charging cable, a remote control and a smartphone mount. The mount has an additional cold shoe where you can attach a microphone, video light or other equipment. The installation sequence is as follows. First, we install the mount on the smartphone and then we attach the display to the mount, which is held in place by magnets. It's convenient that the display can be installed on any side and moved within the holder. This is very important because if you are shooting with an ultra-wide angle camera, the display may appear in the frame. In this case, we simply move it slightly out of the camera field of view. Does the display hold firmly in the holder? Actually, yes, you can just knock it off, you need to remove it manually. In this regard, everything is reliable. So we attach all the necessary equipment to a tripod or selfie stick and get the perfect vlogger set for shooting videos at home, outdoors, on nature, on trips and basically anywhere. To connect the display to the phone, there are two ways. The first, we switch the mode switch button to D, direct connection, then press the power button and wait for about 3 seconds. The screen turns on and instructions are displayed on how to connect to the smartphone. First, turn on Wi-Fi on your phone and connect to the access point named PH01 followed by a few numbers. 2. Go to the screen mirroring section and click on the same name. Literally a few seconds and the smartphone screen is transmitted to this display. That's it, the setup is ready to go. In a world where there are dozens of equipment, manufacturers and hundreds of different models, it's easy to get confused and overwhelmed. Lights, microphones, softboxes, tripods, adapters. How to understand what is right for you and how profitable it is to buy on the Amazon. I have developed a guide to choosing gear for filming talking head videos, which presents different sets of equipment for different tasks and budget, as well as link to purchase on Amazon sites. Link to the guide will be in the description. The second method is to connect via Wi-Fi router. In this case, we can use the main camera for video calls, webinars, Zoom conferences, broadcasts, and other online activities. Switch the toggle switch to mod M. On the phone, we should be connected to our Wi-Fi network. Then launch the camera and scan the QR code on the device screen. Go to the address and enter the settings on this monitor. Press VLAN and in this menu, select and connect our screen to our router. Now both the phone and the display are connected to the same network, while the smartphone still has internet access, unlike the first method where the smartphone connected to the display as router and loses the ability to access the internet. In any mode, you can enter the device settings by scanning QR code. Here we can change the device name and password, select the language, check for updates and reset the device. To change the screen orientation, simply press the power button briefly, and to adjust the screen brightness, press the middle button. There are three brightness levels in total, and even at the highest level, the display is quite readable even in bright sunlight. Overall, thanks to the fact that the display is wireless, we can huge opportunities for creating unusual shots. You can step away to the desired distance from the phone, check the screen, put the screen in your pocket and press the record button on the remote control. Also, with the display, you can immediately determine your most successful movement trajectory in the frame and easily capture a variety of unusual angles for your video. Well, what a cool and useful device, isn't it? But let's go over the downside and see that surprise there are. The first and most unpleasant one, I couldn't connect this display to an Android smartphone. I have a Google Pixel 7a and they just don't see each other. The mirroring function is activated on the smartphone, but the display doesn't show up. Apparently it's intended only for use via Apple AirPlay, although this is not mentioned anywhere in the description or instructions. The second unpleasant point, when recording video in the iPhone stock application in 4K, the streaming starts to lag heavily, the signal is intermittent and the video is recorded with lags too, so in this scenario filming becomes simply impossible. However, in Full HD 13 and 60 FPS, everything is fine. Apparently, the processor can handle simultaneously recording in 4K and streaming via Wi-Fi. I have an iPhone 13 Pro. Perhaps in newer models, this is better because they have more powerful processor. So if you purchase this monitor and use it with newer iPhones, be sure to write about it in the comments so that other buyers know. There is actually a solution on how to shoot in 4K with this monitor. To do this, you need to use the Blackmagic camera application. When recording in 4K at 30 FPS, there are no lags or freezes, but only at 30 FPS. At 60 FPS, there are still lags. Another drawback is that the battery level can only be seen on the initial screen during connection. After that, this icon is not displayed anywhere, making it difficult to understand how much longer the device will work. And now a few tips on how to simplify filming with this device to make it as comfortable and fast as possible. it's best to change the name of this device to something on your own that you will recognize immediately if you are filming in a place where there are many other Wi-Fi networks. I've shown how to do this before. The fastest sequence of action with the devices is as follows. Swipe down Control Center, hold down the Wi-Fi icon, hold down the icon again, select our device, tap twice in an empty space, tap the screen mirroring icon, select our device, tap in an empty space, and tap the camera icon. This method allows you to work with monitor faster because everything happens in Control Center and you don't need to unlock the screen. So friends, I like this device. Despite some drawbacks, it's genuinely useful for content creators. If you shoot a lot of videos for your social media, create educational videos for courses, often have video calls, host webinars and online conferences, then this device will take the quality of your videos and online broadcasts to a new level. Who is this is not suitable for? Those who want to shoot videos very quickly, like point and shoot. For example, for shooting stories, this is not the best option because by the time you connect it and set everything up, the thought you wanted to say on camera may disappear. Also, if you want to shoot in 4K, but don't know how to use the third-party application, such as Blackmagic camera, then this device is not suitable for you, either because there is a recording issue that I mentioned earlier. But overall, it's an interesting device, isn't it? And perhaps you will come up with other ways to use it. Write in the comments if you have any ideas. I remind you that the link to purchase the monitor will be in the description. Please note that on Amazon this device is called Newmowa and on AliExpress it's called Kingma, but it's the same device, just with different names for different markets. Also watch the playlist on how to shoot professional videos on smartphone right here. And as always, dare to create and see you.